Hello, welcome viewers to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our biology from 2 lesson 7, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on transport in plants and the subtopic, the factors affecting the rate of transpiration. Remember we have our previous classes whereby we defined transpiration, but as a recap we can define it again. Whereby we say transpiration is the process by which our plants lose water in the form of water vapor to the atmosphere. Now there are several factors affecting the rate of transpiration, and in our lesson we are going to look at environmental factors which normally affect the rate of transpiration. Let us enjoy the lesson together. Before we get into the body of the lesson, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give the environmental factors affecting transpiration, and at the same time, you are required to explain them. So you'll be very keen on our lesson, and you are welcome. There are several environmental factors which affect the rate of transpiration. One of the factors is temperature, and on the temperature we can say that higher temperatures, this is being represented by the diagram here. So I will just be explaining the diagram as you are watching on the screen. So higher temperature increases the capacity of the atmospheric air to hold more water vapor. High temperature increases the internal temperature of the leaf, which in turn increases the latent heat of vaporization and therefore enhances evaporation from the leaf cells. In low temperature, the rate of transpiration is reduced. As you can see from our diagrammatic representation here, as you are moving, that is on the x-axis, that is being represented by the temperature, while on our y-axis where we are getting the rate of transpiration. The rate of transpiration increases steadily as the temperature increases, but it reaches a point whereby now it starts leveling off. This is because either the temperatures have gone so much high such that the cells, they cannot they are not able to cope with the high temperatures. Remember, the cells, they are denatured by temperatures which are above degrees Celsius. So an increase in temperature will lead to a direct increase in the rate of transpiration until it reaches the optimum. Whereby you can see the optimum is the point whereby it is trying to level off. We have another factor, environmental factor, which affects the rate of transpiration, and which is the wind. On a windy day, the rate of transpiration is high. The reason, because the wind carries water vapor on the leaf surface, increasing the saturation deficit, thus the rate of transpiration is increased. On a less windy day, the air around the leaf surface becomes more humid. This increases the saturation deficit, thus decreasing the rate of transpiration. And as you can see, our diagrammatic representation here, it means that as you can see, the x-axis is being represented by the wind speed, while on our y-axis we have the rate of transpiration. When the wind speed is very high, the rate of transpiration also is very high. This is because when the water droplets, they form on the leaf surface, and the wind speed is very high, they are able to be swept away very fast by the high wind speed, thus increasing the rate of transpiration. Because once the water droplets, they are removed from the leaf surface, other water droplets will be able to get on the leaf surface, and it is something that it becomes cyclic. So that is the wind. We also have another environmental factor which affects the rate of transpiration, which is the light intensity. On the light intensity, you know that light intensity affects transpiration rate by influencing stomata opening. The stomata of most plants open fully in daylight when light intensity is high. This brings the stomata air into direct contact with the external environment. The water vapor therefore diffuses out at a higher rate than in dim light when the stomata are partially closed. It is important to note that in a natural setting, these factors do not influence transpiration in isolation. That is light intensity. On a lighter note, we have got other factors, a factor like atmospheric pressure, which can also affect the rate of transpiration. There are so many environmental factors which are affecting the rate of transpiration, including also atmospheric pressure. There is also availability of water. There is also something like the humidity. But this one we shall direct you where you can get most of these lessons. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity whereby you'll be required to name three environmental factors that affect the rate of transpiration in plants. For more reference, I have already said that there are other environmental factors which affect the rate of transpiration which have not been covered in our lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And also, you can for these and more lessons, you can reach us through our by sending us an SMS on the number that you are seeing on the screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Twitter page, which is at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Thanks for watching, and let us subscribe to the channel that you are seeing on our screen, such that we may get more of our lessons. Thank you, and welcome.